Hi guys, this is just a quick review video about the Blackbird 210 in the normal X layout. I will just quickly show you the frame and what comes with the box. Okay, so this is the frame already pre-assembled. In the box we have some additional more parts. This is a battery cover with some additional foam pads in it to protect the battery from sliding. That's pretty nice. We do have a mount for a GoPro that comes on top of here this way. I will not use it as I'm using a Runcam Split on that. We do have a battery strap from ELACC labeled. Feels quite nice, a bit rubberized, should work fine. And we have some phone standoffs for the bottom of the arms to protect them if you land on concrete, perhaps. The frame itself, I struggled a bit mounting it as I was not using any manual or not using any reference picture. I thought I can just reassemble it, remembering how it looked on the website. But yeah, indeed, I'm not sure why those manufacturers do not include at least a one pager, having at least a picture something. But yeah, okay. This is how you should mount it. I think that's quite neat, as they reduced the amount of screws by double using them. We have three screws to hold the arms. That's quite nice because on some frames you do have a little flex here. If you push the arms together and stretch them, so yeah, there is always if you only use two screws, there's often a bit of play because yeah, the alignment here where they all touch together isn't that good, so there is always a bit of slack. So in this case, not. This is rock solid. I cannot move it at any degree, so that's perfect. That fits really well. We have the first screw that is a lock nut screw that's holding the first. The second is holding also the standoffs that are aluminium that go to the top plate. That is nice. And we have the third one that is holding the mounts for the flight controller boards. So that is a standard mount, I think 30.5 millimeters as usual. So I've put in the PDB that was also included. Looking at the chip that was used, I think that's quite nice. If you do not use any all-in-one controller, I think that's quite usable. Yeah. Okay. From what I can tell is the frame looks really nice. The finish is nice. We have chamfered edges, so these are really nice on touch, so no sharp edges. And what I really liked about the frame is it is very very narrow, so you will have a very efficient airflow, and that was what I was looking for, to have a really an efficient and lightweight frame. If we look at get my caliper, so okay, so I can tell you quickly about some measurements. Okay, we do have an arm thickness of that's okay, I don't get it in the camera, about 5.1, 5.1, 5.2 is the thickness of the arm. The wide of the arm is 8.9, so that's really narrow. Perfect. We do have space for, I think this could be a quad stack even. Let's see, it is 30 millimeters, 30.1 from the bottom to the top. So yeah, that is really nice. So yeah, I really like it. I'll just give you a first introduction. It does not flex at all. You can push really hard. It is absolutely sturdy. I really like it. I like the idea with the screws and using three, and in overall a very nice frame. The only downside maybe could be, I will figure that out in as I mount the frame completely. There is slack in the mounts for the camera at at here, you can see. Yeah, this is wiggling a bit. Yeah, maybe the screws will tight up on the run cam if I screw them in. So there is pressure and it will hold fine. Or maybe I have to use maybe some CA glue or whatever to fix that. This could cause vibrations on the cam. Could. So we will see how that goes. But that's maybe the only downside I figured out on that frame. Except from that, really nice looking carbon finish. So yeah, and also nice mounting options. You always have for zip ties. You have multiple options. I prefer to have my antenna, going vertically to the back. Yeah, not using any standoffs or mounts that go straight up because they get ripped off if you crash. So I think. That is fine. So yeah, and a lot of space in it, and even then it's still lightweight. Yeah, it could be a potential winner. Hope you enjoy the review. Have a nice day.